quick try, he gets to the ball towards Surridge. Johnny Casey lands off his back and he's been cleared away by Boston Town. Only to John Tite though. Tite, good still. Yeah, Jenny's been looking very good down this left flank. Good ball in. Oh, Cherry Tunney got the head on him. It's Redding. It's deflecting. He's going over his head. Cherry, 1-0 to Wellingborough Town. Brilliant finish from Ryan Cherry. Good play for Wellingborough Town. It's 1-0 up after 11 minutes. The Doughboys in full form yet again. Good finish from Ryan Cherry. Good initial shot from John Tite. He created that piece of magic. And Housie, we're 1-0 in front, aren't we? What do you think of it?
That was a great goal. It was fantastic play from John Tite. Before the corner and after the corner, he's going through the bit, being those two players to get the cross in the first place and cause the danger. But also after the ball was cleared, managed to get the ball back in.
Well, the fans are really in. Big cheer, aren't they, Housie? Doughboys is the chant. They're doing well. Let's see what can happen. Wellingborough, probably not the brightest start of them for the three games, but Ryan Cherry makes it 3 goals for 4 appearances, 10 minutes in, and we're 1-0 up. Danny Marlowe to John Tite. Towards Redding, and Redding's solid company. He's picked a good pass there. Just towards the player. Long ball forward from Luke Frey to John Tite. Tite is looking fantastic down this left-hand side. He's done it again. He's undoing this Boston Town defence so easily. Isn't he having a good game, Housie?
He's having a really good game so far. Do you think of it? He used to be playing the left back, but he's going down like a left midfielder so far.
From Casti, look at that. Brilliant turn from him. Sometimes he reminds me of Scott Parton, these little turns. He's really good, isn't he, Housie?
He is a very good player. Very important to Wellingborough Town. Him and Nathan Haycock partnership is very vital for Wellingborough Town.
Yep, Haycock from the reserves. Obviously, reserves not being... there won't be reserves. It's off Ryan Cherry. Oh, my word. It almost went in. Cherry almost gets his second in bizarre circumstances, but that's what you get for working hard. Harewood, yet again, he's going to take him on. Harewood's got such good strength about him, but that's not the best of balls. 1-0 to Wellingborough Town, and they're going all out.
The ball's been down the left-hand side quite a lot this past couple of minutes, so this really hasn't really been much to talk about. But yeah, Wellingborough Town got the ball now. John Tite's doing very well.
Tite, down the left yet again. He's got the ball. It's going to trip the keeper. It's not. It did trip the keeper, sorry. But it went over the top of the net and onto the roof. 25 minutes gone here at the Dodging Duck. Wellingborough Town 1, Boston Town 0. Housie, you've got another word with you.
Yeah, John Tite's doing fantastic down this left-hand side. Because even though he's playing as a left-back, he really is playing as a very attacking left-back. Not really staying back that often, but he's going up front, forward very well. Doing very well, actually. If you think of him as a left midfield, you can tell he used to play left midfield for Urchester, I believe.
John Tite taking more for pace yet again. He's looked fast at number 12, but John Tite's got past him. Good header up there from Boston, but not cleared. It's going to be a goal kick there to Boston. Another attack from Wellingborough Town. John Tite looking brilliant down his left.
Hanging in
by
there,
far the man of the match so
very,
far.
That's very professional looking reserve.
Ball comes in from Luke Craig. It's long and deep. It's towards Ryan Cherry's head. Probably should have done better from that. Housie? That's okay. Just heard the Housie not there. Thought he wanted to say something. Obviously not. Good chance there for Ryan Cherry. Probably done the best that he could. He had Dan Surridge behind him. If he maybe should have received the call, because I reckon Dan Surridge probably would have done better from that position. But Boston, final chance to take a goal for this first half. They've managed to it's a cross. It's not cleared away though, fully from Marlowe towards Harewood. Harewood, look up. Can't. Reading. There's the half-time whistle. Thank you for watching so far. Hello and welcome to WTFC TV. We're here today to see Wellingborough Town versus Boston Town. The halftime score is Wellingborough Town 1, Boston Town 0. It's been a good performance so far by Wellingborough Town. We're winning 1-0 thanks to a Ryan Cherry goal after about 25 minutes. Good performance so far. Hey, how's he?
It's been very good so far. Ryan Cherry's been fantastic. And another promotion is John Tice doing really well down this left-hand side. He's getting in, putting the crosses in. But yeah, Mark Cherry's goal was well taken, and it's been a very good performance so far.
Yeah, it has. It's been a good performance by all the boys, I really think. It's been a team effort. We've had to be, I've had a team effort really for most of the season. There's not been one player that stands out, probably John Tite down this left-hand side, actually. He's been pretty good. But Ryan Cherry's goal, well taken. He's come onto his left and he's had a good shot. I think he's right-footed, so it's a good finish. It was a good finish anyway, even if it was with his right. It took a deflection, I think, off the defender, and it was the first time volley out of the air. Maybe if we hadn't created a goal of season complication, it probably would have been on it, wouldn't it?
Yeah, quite possibly. Yeah, it's a very good goal, and it's a very well taken goal. And well, yeah, only if it did it a little just like a day later, but I suppose there's not much you can do about it now.
There certainly isn't. Chances from Boston, we've noticed that they're good down this right hand side, aren't they?
Yeah, they're doing very well down this right-hand side, and And well, Wimbledon have been doing very well down the left-hand side. So this ball,
it's been a good battle.
Yeah, the ball being down this near-hand side has been very good for Wimbledon Town and for both Boston Town as well. So as long as the ball stays down there, I suppose it'll be a very interesting game.
Yeah, it will. Wellingborough Town, they've got the stronger forwards, I would say. Ryan Cherry in particular. Dan Surridge hasn't really got into the game. We discussed that in the commentary. However, you've noticed something just before half-time, haven't you?
Yeah, I did notice something. There is a very big gap in between our defence and our midfield. Now, I've noticed this quite a couple of times. Whenever there's a goal kick taken, the strikers will be near enough in the final third for Boston Town. The midfield would be about 10-15 yards away, and the defence would be back in our own half.
Yeah.
And it's a very big problem, because if the goal kick isn't very good and it drops down to the Boston Town midfield, who's in front of our midfield, nearer to the ball than our midfield, then you've literally just got 6-on-2 there between the Boston Midtown midfield and strikers versus our defence. And I know our defence has been very good this season, but it's a risk for Wimbledon Town.
It certainly is. We're only one goal up, remember. There's every opportunity that Boston could score. They haven't really had any shots on target, I would say, but there's always an opportunity they could score. We're only 1-0 up, and we've got to be remember that. We're not 3-0 up. The Boston Town players are just coming out. What do you think, Halsey? Do you reckon it'll be a Wellingborough win?
Yeah, I reckon it'll be a Wellingborough Town win. I can see Boston scoring, but I can see Wellingborough Town's... If they could be a bit more prolific, I reckon they'll be 3 or 4, because they'll create a lot of chances. They just need to put them away.
Certainly. Well, we've enjoyed broadcasting this year. I've had Halsey with me. I'd like to say a special thank you to Halsey. He's been here all the time. He's been helping me really a lot, really, with the camera work. Today he's on the main camera. I'm doing the commentary. You've really helped me out. Thanks a lot, Halsey. Just a personal message. So enjoy the second half of WTFC TV, and we hope to see you next season. Well, desperate 3-1 up against Urchester United. Colin Ridgway, manager of Urchester now. He managed Wellingborough Town for the first season in that promotion. But then obviously Nick Ashby came in for the second season of Wellingborough Town, which was by far their highest position. Third they finished in the end. Cherry holds the ball up. He's got to play back to Harewood. He has. Back to Cherry. Cherry takes him on. He's gone past 2-3 now. Hopewell turn across to Phil Cassidy. Nope, he doesn't. Plays it across to Mallet. Plays it across to Cassidy. This is not originally what he's had. Long shot, he's going in. Oh my word. Big chance there for Cassidy. Yeah, how's it?
Yeah, very big chance. There's a good effort from... That was a very good effort from Cassidy. Maybe we can do a bit of the same. Maybe we'll have a couple of goals, but we have to see how it pans out.
Well then.
It should be alright.
Yep. If it does drop though, just tell me.
Yeah. Oh, if he gets one back, I'll tell you.
30 minutes left of this second half. It's Wellingborough Town 1, Boston Town 0. Jared Harewood got a pull wider. Wellingborough don't play with width, and that's something that I really think Wellingborough Town do need to do. Cherry tries to get there. Going for everything, Ryan Cherry. I don't think he deserves to come off. If you're going to bring on Tom Lewis-Edge today or Jared Newman, I'd probably bring Dan Surridge off. He hasn't really done a lot today, which is a shame. He's been very good through the majority of the season.
Yeah, he's been
good ball in from Boston. And Wellingborough keeper hasn't been out. and Boston's still on the ball. He's going lane back. Oh, we've laid it off to the other player, but he's had a shot. It's long. It's going to be a deflection. Is it still scrambling around in the box? Oh, my word. What shot. It's in. Oh, my word. 1-0 now, Boston Town. He's flipped up and he's scored, and that is an exceptional goal. He's taken off his shirt. He's running. What a goal. He's missed the corner flag. Did he go to hit the corner flag and miss it, Alzi? Oh, he's bent it.
Someone hit it. I don't think he hit it, but someone did.
I've snapped it.
It's back up. That's a fantastic goal.
They're celebrating, not they've just won the league, Halsey.
Well, with that goal of quality, they probably deserve it. Although he's going to get booked for taking his shirt off.
1-0 here at the Dog and Duck. An absolutely brilliant goal from Boston Town. A bizarre goal. Yep. So then it's all to play for here at the Dog and Duck. We've got half an hour left for either side to try and get 3 points here. Wellingborough would like to get 8th. I'd like to get 8th. Boston would like to, they could climb up to 12th today with a win here. News from the Kings and Store, it's 3-1 now up. Probably a comfortable victory. Jason Turner scores. He's been good this season, even when he has gone to Kings. He's picked up his goals, that's for sure. He hasn't won them the title. How's he? What do you have to say?
Okay, but Wembley Town have just been very sloppy at the back.
Second, maybe third time. Haycock's through. Haycock's only not scored many goals, but he's getting battler. He's going to keep on him. Harewood, you've got to keep that on. He has. He's getting in a good ball. Who's there? Yes, Ryan Cherry scores again. Good goal from Ryan Cherry. 2-1, back in the lead. What do you think, Housing?
That was a great header from well, Ryan Cherry. Good cross Jared as well Haywood. By Jared Haywood.
Well, what a signing he is. That's 4 goals, 4 appearances now in his last 4. Absolutely brilliant header. I thought Dan Surge was going to get on it. Who would believe it? Yeah. I'm sorry, where did he come from?
That's a goal away from Manchester.
Oh, right, yes. Yes. He certainly was. The Spalding striker, the ex-Spalding striker. He couldn't get in the Spalding squad, funnily enough, Ryan Cherry. However, he's been absolutely brilliant for Wellingborough Town. He scored yet again. A good header. 2-1 now to Wellingborough Town. Come on, you Doughboys.
It's very taking a long time to get back.
And there's the final whistle, and that's the end of the 2011/12 season. It's been a good one, hasn't it, Halsey?
Yeah, it's been a good season. Eighth place for Wellington.
It is certainly.
Yeah.
Thank you very much for joining us at WTFC TV. Thank you to Matthew Howe for being here yet again. Well then, I assume Lombardy have taken the title. Big result there, hey Halsey.
It's a very big result for Lombardy. Just to grab the title from the last day of the season. So, yeah, very big result.
Good result for Wellingborough Town at the end of the season. It's been a strange season. We started off with 4 wins on the trot, and we finish with 4 wins on the trot. Thank you for watching WTFC TV.